Hello and welcome back everyone. So in the last video we talked about the prototype properties in a different objects, right? So we were having human as a function and we created a person one and person two objects from it. So if you're changing some property on the person one, then it was also getting impacted in the person two, right? So in that case, what we did, we removed those properties from the prototype and we put that in the function. Now friends, it's a part of a human function, not a human prototype. So if you're creating a multiple objects, person one and person two, and adding something in the person one, that is not going to be get reflected in the person two because you haven't updated some common reference, because person prototype of the human is a common reference to the person one and person two. So we are updating that in the human functions, not in the human prototype. So if you are adding new Amit, then person one will have all the three names, but person two will not have all the three. Okay, so this is the way we can deal with, and there is another way, which is calling the super function constructor using call method. So here consider this is a super type, okay. So what we have a super type and we have a subtype functions, and subtype is actually is going to inherit the properties of a super type, okay. So what is happening, if all the properties of super type properties are shared among all the child's object, if one child modifies the property of the super type prototype, other children get also affected from this, right. So how can we fix all this kind of situation is, super type is a function. Here we have a three properties. We created a prototype function get super name for this, right? And then we created a subtype. Subtype is another function and added a age also there. And we are calling, while calling to this function, we are calling subtype. And we are doing a call, super type.call. And we are passing first name and last name from with this context. Okay. Now we are creating the prototype, and what we did, subtype.prototype we have assigned to the super type object. This is actually the inheritance we are doing from the super type to the subtype. Super type is a function having all these three properties. Now we created a subtype function and we are directly assigning the prototype of subtype with the object of a super type. This is the actual step where we did the inheritance. Now in the subtype you can add your own properties, and you can call, you can create the instance of subtype and you can call that, right? So if subtype one, if you are adding a Amit in the subtype one, then it will not be available in subtype two. So we are actually talking about solving the problem which is coming on the way due to the prototype. If we are changing something in the object of a prototype, that is getting reflected on other prototype also. So that will get fixed using this, okay. But before going to this, we already talked about this, but how actually the inheritance happens in JavaScript between the functions, right? So I created this super type function. There can be a simple, so now I'm talking about inheritance, not about prototypal object in, object getting changed once one object is changing the property. Leave that aside. So how we are actually doing the inheritance? So this is a super type function. So what we did, super type dot prototype equal to subtype subtype dot prototype. So what we are doing in this line, we are assigning the super type, sorry, subtype prototype to the super type prototype, because super type prototype is already defined, right? So in this case, what we will get, all the prototype methods in the super type, this get super name is there, right? That we also get inside a subtype. We don't need to declare it again. We are actually inheriting this from the super type. Okay. Coming back to the same, here we will talk about how we are actually inheriting. There are different ways of inheriting the parent function features into the child function. I mean, those are independent function here. Like super type, this is independent function. Subtype, this is independent function. So how can I get super name in the subtype, right? So to do that, What I need to do, subtype.prototype inherit the properties of supertype. I can assign that with the object of a supertype, because subtype.prototype also is equivalent to the object of a subtype. And what we are doing, copy all the properties of a supertype object into the prototype of subtype. So whenever I create a new object of subtype, all will have the features inherited from the supertype. Now I added one method in the subtype, get sub age. Okay, now I will be able to call these all the methods, right? Subtype equal to new subtype, and subtype will have a name, subtype will have an age, because age is in the subtype, name is in the supertype. Get super name I can call, get sub name I'm call, get super name I'm getting from the supertype function, get sub age is I'm having in a subtype prototype. Okay, and we already discussed about the problem, right? So if you are creating the multiple objects, so here I created a one object, I created a multiple three objects, subtype 1, subtype 2, right? 1, 2, 3. Now, if you're impacting something on to this, like I'm assigning something to the subtype object here. Subtype prototype dot, so this is a subtype object dot name. It internally actually calling this supertype name property, and it is changing it. So if you're changing it, it's going to be impacted for all of us. I changed Virat to hello. So what will happen? Now you're creating the object, subtype object 1 and object 2. Those will also have the same property, because this you changed in the prototype property. And we already talked about how can we fix it. We can fix it by explicitly calling the call method, or we can fix it by putting the variables inside of functions, not in prototype. So in this case, this will not be impacted. This property will not be impacting all the other objects, because this name property is in the supertype function, not in the prototype. Whatever I was explaining the scenario was something like this. So if you are putting the name property, so if you are putting the name property in the prototype and I'm changing it for object 1, then it will also get changed for object 2 and 3. But here I'm having this name property inside the function itself, so it will not impact, because this is the name property, right? So I took the different example, that's why. But here if you are changing the name, then it is not impacting the others. Okay, that's it. How can we fix this prototypal chaining where single prototype property is changing, other objects are also getting impacted? We can use the call method, like supertype is here, we have first name, last name, friends. Here in the subtype, we can call the supertype, and we can have more things in the subtype, like age I added, right? And I'm just assigning the subtype prototype with the supertype object here in this line, and now I can extend, I'm having all the properties and the prototype features what supertype is having. So this all about the chaining of the function prototype. We will talk more about in this next video.